Okay, first thing you gotta do for rebuilding recoil, and when you wanna change your rope, is you gotta count how many times it spins. So make a nice line in your dirt, or get a marker if you really want to, but just make sure you know where that is, or count from here and go and count how many times it goes around before it loses spring pressure. So that's one time, that's two times, okay, that's three times before it really loses spring pressure. And now that that's loosed, you can take your bolt on here off. You gotta make sure you keep track where everything goes, because this is under, seems like this is under spring pressure. Washer on there too. Square nut on a washer. You see it fits onto a square shaft on here. So the washer and the bolt go together, and then you always have a little pawl system that works on momentum here. It always kicks out. You always want to make sure this is clean and it's not too worn out, and the spring's not all worn out either. So there's a little spring there. And that's what holds that together. And then here's a spring on here that puts pressure on the recoil down, and now you should be able to just lift this off and nothing explodes, and you're all good there. Now what you do is you unwind all your old rope that you want to get rid of, and you, if you see that, it's already to break apart, it's already falling apart there. You gotta try and dig out here. You might need a little screwdriver to try and dig it out. You can just take that, pull that out. What you do next is you take your new recoil rope and match up your old one in length to your new one. And that's about how much you should need. But I always like to, just in case, try and put as much recoil rope on as possible, just in case if the rope had broken before and was a little short. So you gotta stick this through here. And what I do for a knot is I spin this around twice and then shove it through. That makes a nice big knot right there. And you gotta shove that in there as tightly as you can so it doesn't hit anything on the inside of the recoil. Gotta remember which way this goes. Can't remember. See, you see, I'm actually going more than what was on there originally, and see, I can fit a bit more, and that's about where I want to be. I just gotta go around to this final notch here. I have a little bit extra in there. And I can cut that off there. And always, whenever you cut recoil rope, you always have to take a lighter and melt the ends after. And that seals the insulin and you don't fray.
Right on the edge of making the countdown. And we're bringing you the biggest songs in the USA. Lots of requests for this. Someone throw it in it. Say it. Bloom and toe blow.
But that makes a nice, neat little end. And you don't have to worry about it after that. But then you see there's a little notch on here. You have to try and line this up with this little hook on this spring here. And you gotta be really, really careful about the spring, because sometimes it can fly out at you, and then it just makes a really big mess. So you gotta try and line this up with this. See, now that right there spins on there, so you know that's caught on that spring. And so now you bring this here, and you have to go back three times. Before we do that, what we'll actually do is we put this on here so this won't fly apart on here. That's one step I always forget to do the other way. So I've done that before. Yeah, make sure you get that all in there the right way. gotta slide that around there, and that spins really nice. And sometimes it's good to take a little bit of dry graphite, and you just spray a little bit on that pin. It's hard to do a little bit of that with that can. And that makes it just spins a lot better, and your recoil will never skip on you after you do that. And this is the little mechanism on here, and that's what puts on that pawl and keeps this moving. Gotta push this down on the spring and put this bolt back in and feed that back in there. Now with that just on there nice and loose, now you count going all the way around. So that's 1, 2, 3. Now you just gotta bring it back to right here. And you gotta pull your recoil rope out of that notch and just feed it down in through here. You can, sometimes you gotta take a little screwdriver and feed it through like that. And then you pull it through and then you flip this over. And you tie your new knot in there. So then all your work that you just did to coil it up doesn't disappear back into the recoil. There. Now you just gotta snug this back up. And you just rebuilt yourself a recoil. There. Finished. Ready to go back on the sled.